Jeff said we can use the keyboard to go up and down.
Okay, so the idea here is not to talk about anything other than the solution. You know the problem.
Okay.
Just jump right into the solution.
When we're trying to generate chlorine dioxide gas, we first need to put the powder at the bottom. And this box will be sealed, and we can close the door.
Fits perfectly. And we squeeze our bottle. Gas is generated. We're good to go.
One of the reasons why it's so hard to decontaminate a PPE suit is because it's hydrophobic. So it's water resistant. So whenever you have a bleach mist, for example, which is water-based, you spray it on the suit, it forms droplets and basically just rolls off the suit. When we actually have the surfactant in there, it allows basically the solution to almost stick to the surface, coating every nook, cranny, wrinkle of the suit. So you can ensure that after 10 minutes has passed, which is highlighted by the color change, that you know your suit is now sterile. We use color to visualize what has been sprayed. You can spray the entire room. Oh, I've hit this spot, I've hit this spot, I've hit this spot. And now after the color changes, okay, this room is sterile, I'm good to go.
This is our end-to-end user scenario. As you see here, this is our database. This is our hub. This is the command center. This could be with the Ministry of Health, it could be with the local district health management team.
Our project is on rapid decontamination using foam. For this particular purpose, we want this to be as high as possible so that the foam is stable.
Our solution is a 3-in-1 cock system. So we wanted to assess the three problems, the bed problems at home and at hospitals with overcrowding. So this would form as a bed, an ad hoc hospital system. And then we also wanted to solve transport issues, which is why we made it easily carryable, as you just saw us carry it over here. And it's really lightweight, which is fantastic. And then we also wanted to solve another problem, which is transporting bodies which of patients have been deceased.
What I like about the project still is it's really scalable.
Yeah.
So you have a kit that's got the whole thing, the frame, the tentine or whatever to contain everything. But you know what you really need is something you can wrap that body in quickly and safely.
So we're describing an SMS-based system that is collecting information in real time and is making use of both the crowdsourcing data that I've previously described, but also making use of crowd-seeding data. The idea here is that this is a very easily scrapable consistent coding system so that we can easily have a system that is updating in real time.
So early supportive treatment can significantly improve survival rates, especially in rural settings. But the kits that are being sent out right now do not have, you know, basic pain medication, electrolytes, and whatnot.
So it's an apron that slides over the top, is that the way it works?
Yeah, and it's a self-contained apron, and it can be disinfected by itself because it's like standalone. I think the important aspect of it is that it's like, I guess, an anthropological kind of intervention onto existing issue, which I guess the problem's being kind of a reticence or hostility towards workers, trying to solve that aspect.
Basically, you have your measured amount of water in here. There's got a valve on it, so you can control precisely how much water you put in. That starts a reaction, and all the openings are sealed with O-rings.
So the idea is, instead of using Ziploc bags, which they use right now, we can load it in an enclosed environment, so there isn't danger of the box rupturing and releasing that chlorine dioxide gas in an area with people.
Now, we do know that the Liberian government has instituted a hazard pay system for healthcare workers as well as ambulance drivers in Liberia in order to prevent them from quitting. So we feel that it would be necessary to offer that same kind of incentive to a driver that we were training, especially if we're asking them to transport
someone.
So
my question to you is, what is your budget? So how much is this going to cost us?
Yeah. So in the handout, yeah, in the handout, we have a budget in there for training and having a month's worth of 10 drivers trained in this.
So our solution for patient transportation without any viral contamination is a low-cost disposable Ebola containment suit that we lovingly call the EC suit. This suit is optimized for vomit containment, feces and urine containment, air ventilation, temperature regulation, and finally a hydration system.
It's a symmetrical design here. So we have on one side the pouch for collecting the vomit. In the future, we're going to work on a better interface between the funnel and the vomit bag. But on the other side, we have a pouch for additional personal protective equipment. So we changed our design and added a surgical mask that is integrated with a visor here so that the patient can see out.
I actually called up each and every single one of these people to get costs. Of course, You know, it's not written, it's not in writing, but it was a good estimation for what we could do in this time span. And we did get $1.97, yeah.
Well, that's amazing.
it's negotiating with the manufacturers.
No, but it's really, it's extraordinary. It's really cool.